This is fun, but it's not video power, and we have a half hour video power. But first, check this out, a pinball game, the kind that you can play for a dime. Remember that? It's got the lights and the action, but that was then. This is now. This right here is Pinball Quest for your NES. Let's give it a video power review. You get three choices of pinball games. In Pop Pop, you've got to knock out 10 pins like in bowling. Then you've got to sink four balls like you're playing pool. Then there's Viva Golf. Get after the gophers before they ruin the whole course. The third level is Circus. You've got to rack up lots of points to get bonuses so you can play a video level with circus animals, trainers, clowns, and stuff, you know. Then there's the action-adventure game called Pinball Quest. It's got six levels in all. Your weapons are silver pinballs. Use them to score points and collect gold. The more gold you collect, the more things you can buy. You need to buy extra stoppers and flippers to get through the castle. Great game. But now, it's time for Super Glove Ball for the Power Glove. This is a fast-moving game, so we'll switch to slow motion, okay? When you catch an energy ball, move it as forward into the game room as you can. You do that by jamming your Power Glove right towards the television, like this. Now, watch what happens on the right wall. By hitting a question mark, you earn a row wiper. With a row wiper, you can clean out an entire row of blocks just by hitting one of them. Well, here's a tip from Game Players Magazine. It's for Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles on the NES. It's time for another tip. Let's look around level 3 first. To finish this level, you must seek and destroy all enemy tanks. The trick is to use your bullets and save your missiles. But don't waste your ammo either. Always wait a few seconds between shots. When you do use a missile, let it clear a path for you. And then follow it up, and you'll be able to cruise right through this level. Now it's on to level 4. You've got to get all the energy you can for manhole number 16 before you battle the boss. In this screen, you've got to use scrolls, boomerangs, and whatever else you can to smash this laser soldier. Remember, scrolls are the best, but Donatello's staff works okay too. When you're in the sewers, jumping is the key, but don't jump too high or you'll head right to the river. The best bet is to lightly tap the A button, or better yet, use a controller with a rapid fire setting. Okay, that should give you the edge.
When someone mentions bad dream to you, who do you think of? Who has the face that launched a thousand nightmares? Freddy, that's who! And now he's back, but this time he's on the NES. Oh! Just like on the Nightmare on Elm Street movies, Freddy is ready to give you the fright of your life. The object of the game is to search through the buildings on Elm Street, look for Freddy's bones, collect them, and burn them in the high school furnace. There's a great effect that happens when your player falls asleep. You become a dream warrior and get stronger powers to battle the most feared horror legend of all time, Freddy Krueger!
Well, that's all for today. But tomorrow, we'll take a look at a version of Double Dragon for Game Boy.